Good day to the audience around the world. Today is Monday, October 26th, 2020, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfang. Welcome to weekly report of the World New Religion, Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao at Weixin TV Station. Coming first is the information about the grand 99-day ritual that is proceeding now. The 99-day Weixin Shenjiao's annual ritual for Amitabha Buddha birthday celebration for national protection and disaster elimination is held at the 1000 Buddha Zen Ho of our headquarters, Shenfo's Temple. In response to the global COVID-19 pandemic, the ritual prays for 196 countries around the globe under the religious rite given by Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi. May the pandemic subside. Together, we pray for a world without famine and war. Take a look at this week's highlights.
Headquarters, Chantishan Shenfo's Temple of Chantishan Weixin Shenjiao held ritual for Amitabha Buddha birthday celebration for national protection and disaster elimination of the year Gengzi. During the ritual with 99 days, Dean of Weixin Shenjiao Chanting College, Master Yuan Song, led people chanting scriptures on every morning. We also prepared 5 props, flowers, incense, and wine to worship the plague shrouded over 196 countries. With benefits from chanted scriptures, we prayed for disasters elimination, grievances resolving, prosperity and harvest, and no hunger for human beings. Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi gave Weixin Virtuous Fellows some words by saying that,
我们召有微信贤士, 和会大众等, 皆本着, 天命, 为国修道, 为民来祈福的, 原则, 啊, 任劳任怨, 身口意, 不思供养, 法会种种怀疑，这段时间来，所有中文各分支道场、住持法师、神职人员及贤士法公等，已经在巡回一遍了。 这一遍一轮回的服务奉献，是大慈大悲的表现。我们在修行，是借助各种因缘，在不同阶段。 供养我们的心，供养我们的身，供养我们的意念，诵经、念经、念佛、持咒，来回向，给法会坛上各个诸灵。尤其。 每逢有天灾、有人祸，必须要从先从解冤释结开始，才是真正的大修行原则。所以，我们修行的方向，黄禅老祖给我们的修行方向，是大爱，以广义的。 来布施我们的身口意，所以我们时时要去感恩天地之间的恩泽，感谢感恩国家的慈悲，国家的给我们的立足点，所以我们要修行，一定要先从。 大爱来记住，不要 主顾说、哎、我要修行，我要成正果，那是不可能，自己是 不可能成正果。这个时代已经过去了，现在时代是广义大爱的修行方式，先以做利他利众，利他利众啊，你就是受到自利啊，也受到他利的感恩和祝福。尤其我们法文自由蓝天玉皇大帝蓝天圣文而来的啊，所以我们修行的目的就是要让世间平安和谐，这一点很重要啊。所以王禅老祖带我们从这方面再努力。
Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan encouraged people to devote ourselves with selflessness, benefit people, resolve grievances, and eliminate disasters to the public. We would be very proud of Weixing Virtuous Fellow's devotion. Weixing Report, Nantou.
Coming up next is the second piece of Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's footprint. On October 18th,Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi went to Gangshan District, Kaohsiung City, for administering the enshrinement ceremony at Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall. Weixing Virtuous Fellow Mr. Zhang Shuijin, Mrs. Zhang Zhuangmeixiang, and Zhang Xiuping have followed Royal Lord Shi's providence to build the Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall and invite Wang Chan Lao Zu and Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi for its design.After 6 years of construction, the architecture was finally completed. Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall will become a hub spreading righteous Dharma in society. Master Yuan Li of Gangshan Branch Temple and Master Yuan Xin of Tainan Branch Temple of Weixing Shenjiao led virtuous fellows to Tianwen Temple for offering assistance and support regarding the religious rites.Buddhist Master Zhe Hui and many other virtuous monks of Shanjue Chanshi Temple have participated in the enshrinement ceremony and prayed for the Shanjun beings. Now we're showing you the history of Tianwen Temple and the footages of the enshrinement ceremony.
Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall was constructed by following the teaching of Xu Royal Lord.On October 18th, founder of Weixing Shenjiao Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi was invited by Weixing Family Virtuous Fellow Mrs. Zhang Xiuping to preside over the instrument ceremony of setting incense container. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi arrived at Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall at the auspicious time, then started to set the Heavenly Lord and indoor incense container, dotting the icon of Guanyin Bodhisattva.Virtuous fellow Zhang Xiuping piously burned incenses for welcoming Guanyin Bodhisattva to radiantly arrive at the mandala to bless the sentient beings of the local neighborhood for safety and peace. Virtuous fellows Mr. Zhang Shuijin and Mrs. Zhang Zhuangmeixiang were Dharma sponsors of Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall. They both were the devoted disciples of Xu Royal Lord over the past 30 years.And have followed Royal Lord Xu's providence to build the Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall. Through proactive efforts for many years, they completed it, and their daughters, Mrs. Zhang Xiuping, will be the head to organize all related Dharma affairs of Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall. Virtuous fellow Zhang sincerely invited Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi to administer the instrument ceremony at Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall a few days ago.At the beginning of building design, Xu Royal Lord instructed Virtuous Fellow Zhang went to Tanjishan Xianfusi Temple to seek for temple design help from Wang Chan Lao Zu and Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi authorized the architect Director Xie to copy the basic design from Weixing Shenjiao College, so the architectural design of Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall was mimicked the style from Tang Dynasty as well as Weixing Shenjiao.Without Royal Lord Xu of Tianwen Temple, Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall would not be here, Virtuous Fellow Zhang said grateful. Mrs. Zhang had vowed to follow Royal Lord Xu's instructions, devoted herself mercifully to save people from sufferings and benefiting the predestined sentient beings. Mrs. Zhang's thank those powerful people came to her aid during constructions. She was very grateful to the help of Grandmaster Kun Yuan Chan Shi, the architect Director Xie, consultant and construction company, and fully support from Master Yuan Li of Gangshan Branch Temple and Master Yuan Xing of Tainan Branch Temple of Weixin Shen Jiao. After completing the rite of the instrument ceremony, Tianwen Temple's Guanyin Bodhisattva Hall started to launch the benediction and offering rite. Many disciples and virtuous fellows got together to bring their congratulations. The ritual will hold for 3 consecutive days. Chanters will lead disciples to chant the Universal Guest Sutra of Guanyin Bodhisattva, Sutra of the Great Vows of Kasesgaba Bodhisattva, Compassionate Samadhi Hot Water Repentance Sutra, the Compassionate Medicine Buddha Repentance Sutra, and hold Yoga Flaming Mouth Rite to transcend all the predestined sentient beings. Weixin Report, Kaohsiung, Gangshan.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
Yakin.
Next, it's time for the latest update of children's Yijin education promotion. On October 17th, Children's Yijin Education Promotion Center and the public relations team of Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's office collaborated with Zhanghua Xiushui Taiji Branch Temple and Center for Religious Affairs of Weixin Shen Jiao for organizing the scripture reading activity. 20 children from ages 3 to 12 were learning the basic elements of Yijin through dancing and singing at Zhanghua Xiushui Taiji Branch Temple. Cultivating a peaceful and harmonious mind, the children were taught to read the Heavenly Virtue Scripture of Immortal Master Gui Gu by Master Yuan Yao and Weixin Sisters. With their parents' participation, both the children and the parents have certainly enjoyed a wonderful time in the world of Yijin. Weixin TV also videotaped the whole activity for the coming brand new series of Children's Yijin Education Program. Tune in for the new program.
Children are the future of the world. The founder of Weixin Shen Jiao, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, established the Yijin University Education. In addition to the lifelong learning field for adults, he also pays special attention to the area of children's education, so children can be exposed to the wisdom of Chinese culture from an early age and awaken children's instinct wisdom, which will accompany children in their growth and become wise men who can use knowledge to protect themselves and help the public to be safe. Therefore, Weixin Shen Jiao is dedicated to cultivating the country and praying for humankind. The founder, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, encouraged everyone to recite the Heavenly Virtual Scripture of Immortal Master Gui Gu to pray for the sons and daughters of the Chinese nation are connected heart to heart, the permanent elimination of natural disasters and epidemics, and world peace. The Children Learning Yijin Promotion Center has launched a program, Everyone to Recite the Heavenly Virtual Scripture of Immortal Master Gui Gu, hosted by the Children Learning Yijin Promotion Center. It is co-organized by the Weixin Shen Jiao Xiushui Taiji Branch Temple, Research and Development Center for Religious Affairs of Weixin Shen Jiao, and the Public Relations Group of Founders Office of Weixin Shen Jiao. The program, filmed and recorded by Weixin TV station, encouraged people to recite the scripture together and encouraged children to pray for humankind together. The first stop of this program activity started from the Xiushui Taiji Branch Temple, recruiting children from 2 to 12 years old in the Zhanghua area. With the rhythm of the beats, parents and children recited the Heavenly Virtual Scripture of Immortal Master Gui Gu, and the children's dancings were recorded along with the songs. The content of the songs, including the 8 palace, 8 trigrams, and the representative party parts, were taught. The children were also asked to draw pictures of Wang Chen Lao Zu they knew, all of which were very distinctive. After the event, many children took a copy of the Heavenly Virtual Scripture of Immortal Master Gui Gu to form tiles and recite the scripture after returning home, which is in line with the spirits of the Weixin family and the whole nation to reside together. In the future, the Children Learning Yijing Promotion Center will launch more exciting content, and children's program will be recorded at various branch temples. Please look forward to watching the program, Children Learn Yijing, Let's Recite the Heavenly Virtual Scripture of Immortal Master Great Guru together. Weixin reports, Shoushui Taiji Branch Temple.
It's time for Weixin Shenjiao feature story. My colleague is here also sharing with you the real story of how to utilize Yijing Feng Shui in our daily lives. Wish you enjoy the story.
Hello everyone, Amitofu. Welcome to watch Weixin Shenjiao feature story. Today, we will continue to share real cases to you. The Diamond Sutra has instructed people that everything exists like a dream, an illusion, a tiny drop of dew, or a flash of lightning. This is how we should contemplate our conditioned existence. Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi instructed that everything exists in human world with its meaning. It is not immortal, so it could be disappeared. If we as human beings understand this, we will not dispute or bargain persistently or hurt people from selfishness. What we learn, the sentence from the Diamond Sutra, match with and connect tightly with Geng Gua of Yijing. Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi stated that the television program we are watching at every day were all well prepared, arranged, rehearsed in advance to make sure all steps, actions, takes, movement, and so on can present in front of audience vividly. This is the fact to show how it exists. While we turn off the television, everything shut down immediately with nothing left. And what we have seen before everything gone was like a dream or an illusion. Also, the bowl we use while dining were well designed from the material, texture, size, shape, pattern, and so on. This is another fact to show how it exists. If we drop the bowl down accidentally, the bowl will no longer exist as usual, no matter how perfect it was. One more example is election. We can see people from two different parties fight to each other, hurt to each other, blame on each other, set up trap to each other, or make up a beautiful but impractical dream to voters. This is another fact to show it exists. They can cheat people temporarily, but they cannot cheat people permanently. Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi instructed that public officials are existing to serve the public, so their hearts have to be very pure without any impurities. Their hearts can be treated as mountain, no matter it is raining, windy, or suffering from sunburn. It will always exist there, so it is not like a dream, an illusion, a tiny drop of dew, or a flash of lightning. It is like Geng Gua. Geng stands for a mountain, and it exists like a mountain. It is normal that people inevitably be hurted by others, but they can only hurt our skin, the outer layer of our body. They can never ruin our rooted nature. Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi instructed that our friendly heart would only be influenced by Dharma and doctrine. As for other things, impact our hearts are like tiny drops of dew which disappear right after sunlight comes out. If we can understand the logic, we can use the same mechanism to treat people, to live our lives freely. Grandmaster Huiyuan Chan Shi suggested us to keep chanting the Diamond Sutra. Everything exists like a dream, an illusion, a tiny drop of dew, or a flash of lightning. This is how we should contemplate our conditioned existence. While we are suffering insulting our hearts, our hearts will become calm to make things easier, make life easier, and make our rooted nature life more free. Thanks for watching today's feature story. We wish all of you refine Dharma to next level and fill with joy of Dharma. Goodbye.
Take a break. We will come back. Chanxishan Weixin Shenjiao, Jiayi Branch Temple, held its 15th anniversary benediction and disaster elimination ritual on October 18th. The Master Yuan Meng of Weixin Shenjiao Chanting College and other chanters led virtuous fellows to chant Wang Chan Lao Zu profound scripture and other Weixin Shenjiao scriptures. The branch temple host, Master Yuan Zun, guided everyone to express gratitude to Buddha's grace and pray for our nation and the world. May harvest and harmony come, may an eternal end of pests and natural disasters.
Chanxishan Weixin Shenjiao Jiayi Branch Temple held the anniversary disaster elimination and benediction ritual on 18th of October. Abbot Master Yuan Chen led all fellows and other participants to welcome Holy Buddha and gods to arrive the altar, blessing all creatures to live peacefully and safely with wisdom growth. Master Yuan Meng from Weixin Shenjiao Chanting College commenced the altar with other chanters. Fellows chanted the heavenly virtual scripture of immortal Master Gui Gu, Wantan Ultra Profound Scripture, and Weixin Shenjiao Heart Calmness Scripture. The merits of chanting return an offer to all creatures within the Dharma realm. They pray to Bodhisattva for protecting the underworld and human world, resolving grievance, and eliminating disasters and sympathy. They also pray for Taiwan to remain peaceful. Virtuous fellows not only chanted in the ritual, they also assisted different tasks in the ritual. Some of them prepared for Dharma offering food and arranged the Dharma table. The others prepared the lotus seats for the spirits who received the Dharma from chanting. Masters offered Dharma to all spirits in the Dharma realm thoroughly in the presence of sympathy from Buddha. All fellows presented Dharma offerings with sincere hearts with masters, praying for all people to have fruitful living and Dharma enlightenment. The ritual smoothly completed. Virtuous fellows cleared up the venues together. All of them were joyful with the ritual completion. Weixin TV, Jiayi.
Master Yuan Yi, along with other masters and lecturers, supervised the virtuous fellows for a routine cleaning at the starting point of World Peace Taichung Branch Temple on October 18th. After the cleaning, the branch temple was ever solemn and refreshing. Let's take a look.
Chanxishan Weixin Shenjiao Taichung Branch Temple had a group of virtuous fellows work on the cleaning routine on October 18th. Besides cleaning up the dust caused by the construction of the external wall on the 8th floor, everyone was busy wiping the cobwebs and stains here and there. To be prepared for the unveiling ceremony of 33 Heavenly Kings Icon Holy Stone Carving, virtuous fellows here were working on keeping the surroundings clean and tidy. With the comfortable environment, they would piously invite 33 Heavenly Kings to descend and welcome Dharma sponsors and guests on the upcoming ceremony. The cleaning started in the morning. Lecturers and students gathered at Ultimate Plaza, where Master Yuan Yi explained the purpose of the cleaning and detailed the ongoing construction of Taichung Branch Temple. Master Yuan Yi added, the stone carving of 500 arhats on respective floors would follow the completion of 33 Heavenly Kings Icon Holy Stone Carving on selected auspicious days. Then Master Yuan Yi led virtuous fellows to worship Wang Chan Lao Zhu, reported on the clinging to Wang Chan Lao Zhu, and prayed for Wang Chan Lao Zhu's blessing on peace for virtuous fellows and a smooth cleaning. After divided the chores, some virtuous fellows started carefully wiping Wang Chan Lao Zhu golden-hued mega icon at Ultimate Plaza and Wang Chan Lao Zhu golden-hued icon at Wang Chan Lao Zhu Hall. others were busy wiping windows and sweeping ceilings, floors, and walls. Still others were responsible for the cleaning of the icons of 72 heavenly masters at Wangchan Laozhu Hall and the icons of 33 heavenly kings on the walls of the passages on each floor. Since the construction of stone carving, plenty of dust accumulated on the parking lots of lower level 1 and 2. Virtuous fellows also patiently swept the dust off. Also, they cleaned the equipment in the offices and the classrooms. With everyone's effort, Taichung Branch Temple was made clean and tidied everywhere. Weixin Report, Taichung Branch Temple.
Taiwan has enjoyed a relatively stable condition in the midst of COVID-19. Yet, we would like to invite every global citizen to put the prevention measures into practice. Wear a face mask, wash your hands, no touching of the eyes, mouth, and noses. Maintain social distancing. Together, we should fight against the pandemic and maintain the proper functions of our societies. May the pandemic end soon. Thank you for tuning in today. We will be back with more updates about Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 a.m. and 4 o'clock p.m. of the local time in Taiwan on every Tuesday on Weixin TV. May the prayer end and the coming of a harmonious world. See you next week.